Are we sitting comfortably? Are the lights turned down low and the shadows lengthening in the room? Are the curtains closed and are the doors locked? Good. Then let us begin.
There are many accounts of apparitions and noises from the former watchtower at Coleby Grange. Small red and white glowing lights have been seen in the windows of the tower at night. Susan Shreve of the Haunted Lincolnshire website sent me the following accounts that she received from readers of her site. Farm workers have reported that lumps of concrete have been thrown at them when they were working near the control tower. They also get the feeling of being watched by someone unseen. In addition, a dark figure has been seen on the ground floor of the tower, walking down the corridor from the bottom of the staircase, heading towards the front of the building. One of the workers in the fields close to the control tower took one of their children to work with him, and the child disappeared for a while. When it returned, it was asked where it had been, and the child replied, "I've been talking to the men in the tower." One of the young lads who works in one of the businesses across the airfield was sitting having his lunch at the tower when he turned and saw a Polish airman just standing looking at him. The airman then vanished. John Burton, the founder of the former QED paranormal group, wrote to me stating that on a recent visit to Coleby Grange, he found the place to be very active indeed. While there, he felt someone push past him on the top floor, and some strange noises were picked up on EVP recordings. One seemed to be a breathy response to the question, "Are you here tonight?" A second is more distinct, "Hi there." Gary Ross of the Lincolnshire Paranormal Research Team wrote they have made two visits to the Coleby Grange Control Tower. On the first visit, a few strange things happened, including three of the four in the team hearing what sounded like an irate man shouting from the old runway. There was no one else around. Unfortunately, the recording equipment was not turned on when this happened. They also heard several thuds from the inside of the building while they had gone outside of it, which perhaps Gary thought was caused by the structure settling as the night cooled it down. On the second visit to the tower, nothing happened at all. The Believe paranormal team conducted an investigation at Coleby Grange, during which time they heard a crack from a wall, a rustling sound, a sound like a brick moving, something hitting a wall, and 30 seconds later something hitting the floor with force. Both noises were caught on camera. On the upstairs floor, one member felt something touch his leg. At the end of the investigation, a huge bang was heard for which they had no explanation. The Haunted Realm paranormal investigators investigated there on the 11th September 2010, and upon entering the building, a medium noticed that she had seen what looked like a faint man dressed in a pilot's uniform in one of the rooms leading off the main hallway. She also felt that he wanted to communicate with people and would make himself known throughout the investigation. Another member of the team heard a man's voice whisper in his ear, "Don't forget the Polish." Whilst downstairs, in the room where the medium had seen the pilot, they heard what sounded like footsteps going up and down the hallway, which then entered the room and stopped directly behind them. They saw a white mist forming outside the room, and one saw a black figure move past one of the windows. This figure was again seen later. Perhaps somewhat alarmingly, one of the team had a stone thrown at and hit his face, which left noticeable marks. I have visited the derelict watch office at Coleby Grange on a number of occasions, and have personally always found it a very welcoming place, apart from just one time. On Friday the 21st of September 2012, I had experienced the most appalling headache all the previous day whilst riding down to Lincolnshire, and then throughout an investigation at former RAF Woodall Spa with Glenn and Sally Jolly in the evening and early night, and had indeed awoken with it still raging on the Saturday morning. But I promised Glenn I'd ride out on the bikes before I went home north, and so I said, "Ever been to Coleby Grange?" Receiving a negative reply, we set off the few miles to Coleby Grange, just south of Lincoln. I got off my Triumph motorcycle, wobbly and shaky, as though with a bad hangover, and made my way to the watch office. Got the camera out and took a couple of external shots. Then I said a bit about the history and the building type to Glenn, and then we went inside to have a look around through the door on the ground floor. And at first, went to the front windows. And in an instant, all the symptoms of the past couple of days were gone. However, what was most strange about this visit happened after we went upstairs and had a look around up there. For having descended the stairs again, I felt a strange dread of going upstairs anymore. The ground floor felt safe, but nothing would make me go back upstairs again that day. Looking back at the upstairs when emerging from the building, there seemed to be no cause to my feeling of dread. But it was an overpowering feeling. Do not go up those stairs. Someone didn't want their privacy invaded. It was an interesting visit to Coleby Grange. However, any plans to go back have at present been curtailed, as the building has been fenced off. In a way, the fencing off the building is a good thing. It will stop the mindless vandalism and graffiti. In another way, it denies us of another structure from the fast disappearing RAF Airfields, and indeed, one that has produced so much phenomena and so many accounts.